This is Josje from CAPRO. Today we are going to do a post-mortem examination on a broiler breeder parent. So this is the bird. They have been laying for about a year, and nowadays they are changing the feathers so they can take another round. And we are going to do a post-mortem to see the difference in gut health, and also to see the difference between if you take a post-mortem on a bird which is already dead and a freshly opened bird. So this bird died about 15 minutes ago, and now we are going to dissect it. So what you do, you first make a small incision here in the stomach, and you pull the skin towards the head. And here you see the breast muscles, which is the meat. Then we take a pair of scissors and start opening up here. So here you can already see the abdominal fat. And see the abdominal fat. First you look into the beak, where you don't see any discharge. Look into the eyes if there is no discharge. So this all looks fine to me. And you see this as a strong broiler breeder. So normally when you do this on a broiler chicken, it's all a little bit easier. So now you start looking at the esophagus and the trachea. The trachea looks nice and clear. And when you cut it open, there should not be any mucus in it. And you see here, there's a little bit mucus in it, but for the rest, it looks all clear. Then we go up to the belly. What we need to do is to pull all this open. So what we do is pulling the whole intestinal system out. Gut health is very important in poultry. If chickens have a healthy gut, they usually also have a healthy immune system. And the gut is usually the place where a lot of diseases can enter. So if you want to prevent intestinal diseases, what you can do is using acidifiers. You can use acidifiers which go into the feed, or you can use acidifiers which go into the drinking water. From CAPRO we have two products which go in the drinking water, the CAPRO Full Skull Oral and the CAPRO Fix Oral. And if you're talking about feed, we have the Immunogam. And we have the Immunogam Plus. So what is the difference? Well, the difference is that those three, they are not capsulated. So that means that when you get a shift in the pH, their mode of action will disappear. So that means that they will work in the esophagus, they will work in the crop, but the pH of the stomach of the poultry, of the chicken itself, is between 2 and 4. So here, their action will be stopped. So you see the immunogram, caprofoscal oral and the caprofix oral. They work in the esophagus, the crop and part of the stomach. Then you will say, well, if they're only usable for this small part, why should I use them? Well, this is because in this point, they can already kill a lot of bacteria. And if you use them in the drinking water, they will also kill the bacteria in the drinking water lines. And in this little part, the feet will stay into the crop for a while. And they will start digesting the proteins. So you get part digested proteins and the chicken can digest the proteins much easier. So that is the point when you're using non-capsulated acidifiers. Then we have the capsulated acidifiers, like Immunogram Plus. So this is on basis of butyric acid and it's capsulated. So what happens? Here it works only partly because it's capsulated. In the stomach, the capsules are released and the fatty acids, they go run freely. So that means that they work onto the entire intestinal system. So if you're having problems with a disease like Salmonella on a farm, it's good to use Immunogram Plus because it works into the whole digestive system. And the second thing is that with the butyric acid, the Salmonella won't attach to the gut wall and the chickens won't become ill. What we'll do later, we'll have now this entire digestive system and this is old. If you cut it open, you can see that if you look at the gut, there's not much anymore you can see. Because it's been too long now. You can see there's quite a lot of fluid now in the gut. And if we do it like this, you can see it's a little bit red and a little bit thickened. But for the rest, it's all fine. But it's a little bit too thick and a little bit too red. Then if we look into the cecum, which is a very important place for coccidiosis, this looks perfect. And then very important is also to look here, because here you always have the lymph nodes of the gut. So if you have like a viral infection of the gut, you have the lymph nodes here and those are not enlarged. So the gut health of these chickens was quite good. Then we also need to open the stomach. You can already see it's quite old already. And you see the lining is perfect. So the gut health of these chickens was very good. This is the broiler breeder from the same flock we just saw the postmortem from. So these birds, you can see they're very heavy, very big. These are Ross birds, they are in very good health and they are bred here in Holland. And now we will do the second postmortem on this one to compare the guts and also to compare whether it makes a difference if you did a postmortem on a chicken that's already been dead for a while or on a fresh one. If we're doing a postmortem, you first look at the outside of the chicken. So here what you can see is that the wings, they are a little bit a problem because the feathers are falling out, but that is because this farmer is changing the feathers of these birds because he wants to use them for another round because they're so expensive. That's fine. Then you look at the comb. when animals are laying, this should be totally red. This animal is at the moment not laying and stressed because he's not getting enough food because of the changing of feathers. And then you look at the eyes, if they are clear and don't have any discharge, well, this is all fine. Then you look at the nostrils, if there's no discharge, and also if there's no discharge from the beak. So this all looks fine. Then we start to do the post-mortem. What we first do is cut it open here a little bit. And pull it towards the head. You see this animal is very muscly, much more than a layer or a broiler. No point bleedings. Everything looks absolutely fine. Then we start at the beak. Cut it in here. And here. If you start to look at the trachea, you cut it in and you cut it totally open. And you want to have a look if there is any mucus or any swelling in the trachea. If you look at this trachea, it's totally dry and looks absolutely perfect. So these animals didn't have any respiratory problems. Then we start to have a look at the belly. So we get it open like this. We pull it like this. And now you can see the liver, the heart, and the abdominal fat. And underneath the abdominal fat, we can find the guts. Just cut this open. So here we have the stomach. And here we have the guts. So as you can see, they are nice and pink and there is no problem you can see. And also the liver is very nice and of a good color, because if you have fatty liver, it would be a color like this, and this one is more nice and red. This is the digestive system of the second chicken we did the post-mortem on. And this one is now fresh. And what struck us when we laid it all out, that it was much longer, because from the second chicken, the first chicken, it was already shrunken. To look at the inside, and you will have a much better view as well. You see now how thick it is, how nice the color is, and you can really look at the aspect of the gut. And here that was not possible because it was already decomposing. So we'll cut it in at several places. You see how neat this is. Those chickens have a very good gut health. So this is some food what is left there, but you can see the gut wall. It's completely intact, no redness, no bleedings, and of normal size. Then we look at the lymph nodes, which are exactly here. And this one, in the contrary to the other one, is activated. So this can mean that or it's just been vaccinated, or there can be a viral infection present in chickens. So this is the place where you always have to look in the gut to see whether it's red and swollen. And this one is indeed a little bit activated. So that is in a very big contrast to the very good gut health the chicken has. During the postmortem, we talked about the importance of good gut health. Solutions of CAPO, which can help you establish a good gut health in your animals, are Immunogam, Immunogam Plus, CAPOfix Oral, and CAPO Full Skull Oral. Immunogam is a product which can help you prevent coccidiosis and help you in a good digestion because of the oregano essential oils in it. Immunogam Plus is also a product which contains oregano essential oils, but contains also calcium butyrate, which has a preventative action on salmonella. So in case you have salmonella problems on your farm, you can use Immunogam Plus. CAPO Full Skull Oral is a product which contains calcium and phosphorus, but also contains acids. And those acids, they can help releasing more calcium and phosphorus from the feed and get a good eggshell strength and good bone strength in your animals. CAPOfix Oral is also a product which contains of acids. In it is essential oil from clove, and this also has an antibacterial effect, and the acids will sort of make sure you've got a good digestive system and also a good immune system in the gut.